spring is finally here, and that means that it is Sakura blooming season, or our season of cherry blossoms, and what we call Ohanami, which is like picnicking under the cherry blossoms that we all collectively do during this season. Now there are like over 100 different types of Sakura in Japan, but at the end of February and beginning of March, there is a very vibrant colored Sakura called Kawazu Sakura that blooms during this time. So if you come to the town of Otsumi, which is right hop skip away from the small Mitsukushima Jinja on the far side of our island, there is a premier viewing spot for this vibrant colored Sakura, and we're gonna go see it today. So let me give you a little preview of what we're talking about. Superman style! Me, have a look around. Enjoy the pink. And it's just this nice, really soft pink. Yeah, this color's a lot different than the normal Sakura, which is more like a pale whitish pink. And then this one, you have more of a magenta hue to it. So it's got a lot more color. And there's just birds everywhere, like just birds flying in and out of these trees and eating things, and so full of life.
These cute little green birds are called mejiro in Japanese. The blossom's nectar is a tasty treat for them, and as a result, they help pollinate the trees. They're very happy birds indeed.
So I said that Ohanami means picnicking, well, you know, picnicking and viewing the flowers. Well, we take that really literally here. So I have brought with us some bentos and some drinks and some snacks, which we can enjoy while we soak up all of the sights of spring here.
Okay, can you explain what you got?
Sure. So we picked up these bentos at Michino Eki. This is the katsu sandwich. You wanted this is like kaisen don, So sashimi over rice, and then for me, I got like, I forgot what this was, Thai red snapper over rice. Thai mishi, yeah. Red snapper over seasoned rice, specifically.
Looks good.
Yep. So we're just gonna eat, and we're gonna relax, and we're gonna touch some grass, because I think we all really, really need to do a lot of that since we're all cooped up for 2 years because of COVID. So yeah, seriously, people, touch some grass and some Sakura. Okay.
So that is from hotel Sunshine Sazanseto.
Oh yeah, which is not far from here. It's just on the other side of that cape. So yeah, this one's from Sunshine Sazanseto.
I think Katsando is also from, yeah, that's hotel.
The hotel food, okay.
Mm-hmm.
What about yours?
I don't know. Ah, this is just from the fish. local fishermen.
Yeah, I bet you that, man, you're not going to get much fresher than that. They probably caught it this morning.
Is it good?
Mm-hmm. It's red snapper. Oh, yeah, it's good.
That's your favorite fish.
It is my favorite fish.
How about yours? Right?
Yeah. I got the cream and sandwich.
Ah. Looks good.
This is what I was looking forward to the most, right here. That's the sound of unbridled joy. I am an Osan at heart. That means I have, like, the spirit of a 90-year-old dude in the body of a 38-year-old woman. My joy is drinking beer, eating salty snacks, and smoking cigars. I'm not joking about that either. I like all three of those things. And then also a little whiskey on the rocks. I was raised by wolves, I swear. You gotta count.
Okay.
You gotta cover your eyes and count.
Okay. 1, 2. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There you are!
Ah, you found me! Good job!
Mommy, oh hi!
Okay,
I'll
count. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So around the area here, there's some donation boxes where you can give a little bit of money to help maintain the trees and the flowers. So I would definitely recommend doing that because this is all community run. So we're gonna go ahead and... Yeah, let's give all these coins.
Okay.
500. Go ahead. Yeah, you can put all of it. But it's just to show our appreciation for this because we come here every year. And we usually have a little picnic here, so we always try to give something.
Yeah.
Good. Okay. Good job, Ray. Good way for us to be good Samaritans. Piggyback again. Okay. We're not going that far. I want to explain the parking situation because I think if it's your first time coming here, it can get really, really confusing really easily. So there is a sign here. It says, please do not drive up this road leading to the actual Sakura. There's two parking lots. There's one on this end where you can see the pink flowers over there. That's the first parking lot. It usually gets full really quick, especially if it's a weekend. So the second option is actually just to walk down to where the Itsukushima Jinja Shrine is and park over there. It's only about a 5-minute walk, so it's not that big of a deal. But yeah, please just don't drive up this road because this is for the pedestrians going for the Ohanami or Sakura viewing. So
for
yeah,
local
for the local community too. So yeah, please don't drive up here. Well, we've already been here a couple of hours and this is a really nice relaxing spot to have a picnic. It's definitely easy to kind of lose track of time, especially when you're really paying attention to the sounds and the smells of nature. Sakura, usually it only blooms for a very short season, and this one is already in full bloom, so I have a feeling that probably by next week it's going to be gone because we're expecting rain on Monday. So yeah, you have to kind of time your visits right if you want to see especially this type. And then the next one that's blooming, of course, is the normal, the pale white Sakura that most people are used to seeing. So, but this one, yeah, I think it's done for this season, and it's only the middle of March, so it's too bad. I'm noticing it's not that busy though, because even for, like, it's Saturday today, even for a Saturday, this is particularly quiet. But then again, my comparison for everything was what I experienced in Tokyo, which is like an insane comparison, right? So, like, there's only been maybe a handful of people kind of coming in and out and viewing, taking photos, and then leaving relatively quickly. So, for Sakura, this is a very quiet spot, and I would say very kind of open. So you don't have to feel pressured or rushed to be in and out because there's like a huge wave of people coming. So that's the nice thing. I definitely like this spot because of that. Well, that's it for this video. So we thank you again for watching and hope you enjoyed our Ohanami with us this year. If anyone ever wants to come out and see this, please absolutely watch our video and take some of the information that we gave you there. Hopefully it will guide you to this beautiful little Ohanami spot here on SuoOshima. Until then though, we will see you on the next video. Bye-bye!